the unknown known. Despite others' attempts to identify a certain number with Satan, it will be known that 9 is his number. 9 is the number of the ego, for it always returns to itself. No matter what is done through the most complex multiplication of 9 by any other number, in the final equation, 9 alone will stand forth. The true ages of time are cast in the likeness of 9, with all cycles obedient to its law. I started 9 Sense on that premise. That was The Unknown Known by Anton Zander LaVey in his collection The Satanic Rituals. 9 Sense from the beginning has operated with the positioning statement of a satanic perspective of our modern world. That's where I started, 5 years ago. But as more and more contributors came on board, we really were operating under the guise of the greater satanic conversation. That was where we moved to. You know, I had 9 active segments up until today. And that's no longer, because today I'm announcing the end of 9 Sense. You know, I've had a really good run performing, conducting, producing this podcast. It's been a really enriching experience. But as all Satanists understand, life is about indulgence. It is about experience. It is about setting goals and achieving them. And I feel like I did that with 9 Sense. I truly don't think that there's anything else I could contribute to the greater satanic conversation that I haven't said already. After 5 years of amazing content, with fantastic interviews, with some really prominent individuals that exemplify Satanism in action, in life, I think it's time for me to focus, rather than entertaining others, in achieving other goals that, quite frankly, producing this show has stopped me from being able to complete. You know, producing this show every week is a significant amount of time, the rewards of which are the interactions I have with you, the audience, the interactions with the other contributors, and hearing your feedback helping me grow not only as a entertainer, but also an individual Satanist. Hearing your interpretations of the particular perspective that we're giving on this show. You know, not everyone agrees that listens to this show with my personal politics or ideas, my particular third side perspective, or the other contributors for that matter. But you tune in anyway, and that meant a lot for a long time. So I want to give a heartfelt thank you to everyone that has made this podcast, quite frankly, the number one satanic podcast in the last 5 years. We have been the standard to beat, and it is because of your feedback, your interaction, and your contributions. Thank you very much. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention or even allow the other contributors to have an opportunity to say goodbye to you, their audience as well. Some of them will be continuing on in different venues with different podcast hosts, or maybe even their own. Some projects will be ending, others will be picking up under their particular wit and wisdom that they like to share. I support every single one of the contributors in their future endeavors. I can honestly say everyone that has had a piece of this show, everyone that has put a part of their heart and soul into this, they are the tip of the satanic spear in action. You know, we always have to remind ourselves that Satanism isn't about hanging out online or in a room talking about how evil you are. It's not about spending your life conducting greater magic rituals or burning effigies at the stake, because we all know we do that a lot, burning effigies. Anyway, it's not about that. It's about living life. It's about getting out there. Quite frankly, between this podcast, I have been giving up on living life. I have been cutting short my family time, my professional time, and other hobbies that I've wanted to indulge in. And that's why I'm going to have to stop. I'm going to give it over to some contributors that wanted to say goodbye to either their own podcast segments or to 9 Sense as a whole. And I'll see you on the other side.
A Eulogy to 9 Sense by Darren Deicide. I knew that this day would come. There had been rumblings for a while, and the sense that 9 Sense would not last forever. All good things must come to an end, so the saying goes. But that's really just a bomb for missing something. And while not all good things must come to an end, there is also a piece of myself that is relieved to see it go. As the murky straits of podcasting continue to flood with just about anyone who has a microphone and a computer, the foibles of podcasting make themselves more and more apparent. I don't remember the exact sequence of discussion that brought me to Agent Provocateur, but I do remember having an uneasy feeling about the proposition. For one thing, I really do not see any intellectually convincing connection between my chosen subject and Satanism. The social sciences are certainly worth the time given to it in helping to understand institutions, how they function, towards what purposes they function, and what that means to individuals. However, Satanism's pragmatic individualistic approach demanded no orthodoxy in where to place interest. One could view institutions from an exploitative point of view, looking for ways to glean benefits towards oneself, or one could view institutions from a power point of view, looking for ways to influence institutions in ways that could gravitate society more towards a pentagonal revisionist world. Possibilities are wide and depend on the value systems an individual Satanist would construct. So I didn't want to assume any mandate, nor was I interested in being another pundit or demagogue. However, I also did not want to be another droll analyst with pretensions of the McNeil-Lehrer report. Things would require a new approach, and 9 cents actually seemed like the perfect place. Thus, Agent Provocateur was born. And while it was a comfy home for a long time, I think podcasting may have worn its welcome as a viable medium. Much of the internet has been reduced to static, and this should be of no surprise to the Satanist who has watched this hurting tool be utilized by mass media, not only to give platform to half-baked satanic offshoots and people with far too much idle time, but to continue to sap Satanists of their role as producers, instead opting to join in the pointless fracas and endless grandstanding that defines, quote-unquote, social media. Social media is a worthless endeavor for people whose lives desperately need placebo, not those who live a rich life of achievement. Indeed, I take solace in knowing that 9 cents may be leaving at just the right time, a high note. For me, the end of 9 cents marks the end of an era. There are a million podcasts out there, but 9 cents stood out from the rest. In the time that I've done Agent Provocateur, I've seen podcasting evolve a bit. Undoubtedly, it has become a ubiquitous medium for many niches. In that sense, podcasting shines, as it contributes to specialization of the arcane. No doubt, this has satanic value. But as with any democratic medium, its sheer accessibility also allows for a cesspool of poorly thrown together broadcasts that lack any of the traditional timing and rhythm that we've learned from radio greats of the past. Instead, people are able to tap a record button and regurgitate the first inane thought that comes to mind. Thus, the double-edged sword of the internet-slash-entertainment immaculate conception rears its ugly head once again and shows that while some forms of media technology could be used towards interesting ends, never doubt the ability of the average person to use it as a full frontal display of just how average they and their audience are. 9 cents distinguished itself from this. 9 cents had beautifully produced segments, much like Golden Age radio. It had the pacing of a classic variety show. I often listened to 9 cents as I prepared my morning breakfast, and though 9 cents never aimed to be retro in this respect, it lent itself to that traditional role of stimulating the mind and tickling the funny bone as a kickstart to the day, an intellectual cup of coffee. Each segment had top-notch production values with introductions, trailers, theme music, and such. 9 cents was setting standards that one rarely heard in a podcast. Captained by Reverend Adam Campbell, it was clear from the beginning that 9 cents was going to be a maverick amongst mavericks. One could tell that Adam was passionate about the subjects and the contributors. Not only was it exceptional in quality, it was willing to tackle the most taboo of subjects, from occult history to sexuality, all the way to what's making headlines. But what I love so much about it is that it insisted on never losing its sense of humor. I am always amazed at how susceptible to stodginess a group of people is whose cornerstone idea is indulgence. Well, Nine Cents wasn't going to have any of that. Nine Cents saw no conflict between decent scholarship and a damn good time, and for that, I will forever miss it. The no-holds-barred approach to subject matter was refreshing, and a piece of me laments what forms of groupthink could arise without the voice of something like Nine Cents to challenge everyone. I cannot thank enough Reverend Adam Campbell for making this show happen. He is a true firebrand, a great host, a talented producer, and a real leader. His drive is unparalleled for making Nine Cents the consistent quality show that it was for many years. I will miss all the comedy, banter, and insight that defined Nine Cents. As the curtains close, I look forward to finally being able to redirect my energies towards more effective ways of engaging the world. The flame that Nine Cents burned will forever sear itself into the psyche of Satanism and those for whom independence of mind and body are not open to negotiation. And so, it is done. Hail Nine Cents!
Nine Cents is legend. It will be spoken of with reverence and treated as the great satanic conversation. I'm truly honored to have contributed to that conversation and have my name etched upon the muddy monolith that's Nine Cents. What made the show a work worthy of immortality is the honest and sincere exchange of ideas that went beyond quoting the Satanic Bible or parodying Anton LaVey's quips. It was a discussion, first and foremost, a discussion amongst Satanists, wildly different Satanists who apply our infernal philosophy to their own interests, and in that bring about a third side to each individual subject. Nine Cents turned out to be the definition of the third side. I'm sorry to see Nine Cents end, but I know our great host, Reverend Adam Campbell, will not cease dazzling the ranks of our church. He has always impressed me, from our private banter to his public statements. He is truly an exemplary person and a powerful sorcerer. Without his leadership and drive, my small contribution wouldn't have been what it is. He challenged me, as my fellow contributors have, to be greater, to always do greater. For those who've listened to my segment, interacted with me about the various subjects, have joined the Mattress Squeaking March, thank you. Thank you for posing your questions, forcing me to triple-check my points of research, for reminding me why I did militant eroticism to begin with. But I mostly want you to know that you've inspired me, as I hope I've inspired you, to remain the filthy little perverts we all know that we are. I want all of you to remember something for my part in Nine Cents. I know I've said it many times, but I think it's always worth repeating. There is nothing wrong with what you want. And there's nothing wrong with enjoying what you want to its fullest. Celebrate your perversities. Celebrate your fetishes, your sexuality, your lust. Never betray what gives you pleasure. And I'm not speaking specifically about sex. As always, my fellow eroticists, my dear listeners, keep your skirts up. Keep your pants down. And no matter who bends over, always be militantly erotic.
Hi there, this is Warlock M.A. Mandrake. Satan represents indulgence, not compulsion. And Reverend Adam Campbell has worked so hard on Nine Cents, it must be a compulsion by now. I mean, come on, week after week after week would have left me weak. When Adam started Nine Cents, it filled the void left in my ear when Magister David Harris ended his Satanism Today podcast. And when the latter recently became part of the former, I... Jeez, that was pretentious. Anyway, Adam not only resurrected the greater satanic discussion pioneered in Satanism Today, he also brought back Satanism Today. Now that's an ending with a twist. Believe it or not, I actually listen to this show. It's one of the few podcasts of which I listen to every episode of which... of... So I'm gonna miss it, both as a listener and as a contributor. It has been an honor and a privilege to have my turn on this here soapbox, and with such fun, passionate, intelligent individuals. But if idle hands are the devil's playthings, as the old saying goes, then look out. Adam just opened up his toy box. I've spent time with Adam in person, more than once, and he's pretty much exactly how he seems on the podcast. But I like him anyway, and wish him the best. On that note, this is Warlock M.A. Mandrake saying, Hail Nine Sense, and Hail Satan.
Well, Adam, it's been a good run, and you have produced a lasting legacy for the Church of Satan and its members. And I'm proud to have been part of the Nine Cents podcast, even for this limited time. But it's time to move on, ever forward, as they say. And I wish you good luck in all your future endeavors. That's the way that Satan takes a holiday.
Hello, everyone. This is Magister David Harris of Satanism Today here on the Nine Cents Podcast, chiming in to say goodbye. Yes, we are saying goodbye to the Nine Cents Podcast. Reverend Campbell, after 9 years, is deciding to bring this wonderful show to an end, and I, for one, want to thank him and all of the contributors to the Nine Cents Podcast for furthering what Reverend Campbell calls the greater satanic conversation. So much of the work that has been done on this show over the course of the past 9 years has been nothing short of phenomenal. But as one door closes, another one opens, and I would like to invite all of you to tune in to Sex, Song, Cinema, and Satanism with David Harris. Yep, that's me. As we discuss and talk about things that I find interesting, and hopefully you will too. A lot of your favorite Nine Cents contributors will also be contributing to Sex, Song, Cinema, and Satanism with David Harris. So be sure to check it out. The first episode will air on January 11th. Just go to davidharrispodcast.com to check it out. You can also check out all of the things that I've got going on, including some of the films I've worked on and produced, both in the comedic and pornographic variety, as well as anything else I feel like talking about. So it's all going to be there. DavidHarrisPodcast.com. Sex, Song, Cinema, and Satanism with David Harris. Be sure to check it out. DavidHarrisPodcast.com. And to Reverend Campbell, I say thank you very much, sir, for everything that you've done over the course of the past 9 years. And, of course, Hail Satan.
So how do you say goodbye to something that's been as huge a part of my life as Nine Cents has? I'm going to make it quick because nothing I say can do it justice. I'm going to miss my contribution. I'm going to miss doing the show with Adam. I'm going to miss the contributors, such a sense of community that we had. We had a lot of fun. Of course, it's on to a new chapter, changing of the guard, and I'm excited about the new iteration of this podcast, but nothing will quite ever be the same as Nine Cents was. I was so honored to be asked to participate, and I had so much fun month after month, just doing the research, playing the songs, getting the feedback, just so much fun, so edifying, so enlightening, such a sense of purpose it gave me. So this is the end of Nine Cents, a new beginning. Thank you, Adam, for everything.
This is Heather Height. I'd like to give a quick thank you to all of the Nine Cents listeners and my fellow contributors, and a special thank you to Adam for allowing me the opportunity to I don't know, yap every week to everybody. I haven't been involved very long, but it's been very educational, and I had a lot of great opportunities to talk about things that I care about. I'm going to continue my Something Different segments on sex, song, cinema, and Satanism with Magister David Harris. So I look forward to continuing my yapping. Thanks, everybody. Bye.
So long, farewell, our readers, and good night.
I hate to go and leave this pretty sight.
So long, farewell, our readers, saying adieu.
Adieu, adieu, to you and you and you.
So in closing, I would like to thank you again, the audience, and the contributors. Down to the Crossroads, which Erin Casavall is absolutely stunning at what she does, and I am so proud that she has been the longest-running contributor to this podcast. You can't argue that what she does is quite amazing, and she shares it with all of us, which is fantastic. Agent Provocateur with Darren Deicide, it's controversial, it's very witty, it's insanely funny at times, but thought-provoking at the same time. You're not going to get much better of a news analyst from a third-side perspective anywhere else. Militant Eroticism with the Den Ardennes, speaking to human sexuality, encounters, development. It's truly a stunning, stunning show. I Dream of Jesse with Jesse. It's one of those segments that no matter your politics, no matter where you come from, you're going to benefit from hearing what she has to say. And she says it in her own particular way, which is thought-provoking, profound, and really resonates with satanic wit and wisdom. Unorthodoxy with Witch Zaftig. You can't argue that this witch is really at the forefront of understanding what Satanism means as a religion. But sharing her vast scholar religious-based experience with us every single month is, I mean, it's an untapped resource up until then. Thank you, Witch Zaftig. You've done such an amazing job, and it's going to be a segment to be missed. The Satanic Tradition with Reverend Merciless. Though we've only had four of these episodes, each was packed full of truth in satanic history. Pulling aside all of the bullshit that we've all been told was the truth, and we were shown through a satanic lens where we come from as a satanic tradition. Between the Horns with Warlock M.A. Mandrake. I mean, this is produced so well, so original. It has such its own powerful flavor. I mean, people want M.A. Mandrake to narrate their lives, let alone enjoying what this show has brought. So thank you, Warlock. You've done such a great job, and you are truly a very funny individual. Something Different with Heather Height. You are an amazing comedian. You have brought such a wonderful sense of humor to the podcast that is so different than what has been offered before. Your analysis of cartoons, of humor, of comedy, of brands, delivery. It's really been an honor to have you on the podcast, and thank you for your contributions. And finally, Satanism Today with Magister David Harris. My friend, this podcast existed because really of your inspiration. To have you become a part of it was simply amazing. Thank you so much for your help. And I know that you're going to be moving forward with another podcast, and some of the contributors are going to be joining you. And I look forward to hearing that at whatever interval, weekly, monthly, yearly, however you produce it. I'm an audience member. I'm quite literally looking forward to that too. Really carry on the tradition of the greater satanic conversation as we have collectively defined it here. To the hierarchy of the Church of Satan, your support has meant everything. Thank you so much. And really, I guess that's the end. Thank you so much for joining me and allowing me to take you on this very strange journey every single week for the past 5 years. I guess for the final time, I've been your host, Adam Campbell. And until we see each other again, hail Satan.